Alright guys, welcome everyone to another episode of Fallout 4. I'm Vegeta and I'm once again... my slipper just fell off my foot. I'm once again co-hosted by Rin again.
Hello guys.
Who's joining me on this epic quest, although we missed some
six.
Episodes.
Yeah, I guess it was six episodes.
And after we got the Courser, we got the teletransporter ship, but we don't know how to use it. So we got to find some guys that are called the Railroad, and I found them. There they are.
Okay, there they are, okay.
There were some puzzles involved, actually, and they were really cool. Shut up, Deacon. That guy actually saved us. You see, I ditched dog meat for...
Don't try anything.
For
Nick.
Runner friend.
For Nick, yeah. And I am supposed to talk with Desdemona. I hope that's how she calls. This individual is busy, apparently. Let me just put this a little bit louder so we can hear. Railroad HQ. No, yours. Why? Can I open them? That was strange.
So basically, our guesses were right. The kid is with the Institute.
Yeah, the kid is with the Institute. And is.
Of course, he's. Institute.
He grew older. He's like already almost 5 or 7. I don't know.
Oh, really? That is a strange.
Our visitor here has a Courser chip.
Whoa! For real? Oh man, it's been ages.
Right.
That guy seems excited.
Tom can get you the code, but once he's done. We get the Courser chip.
Sure.
Why do you want the Courser chip?
Institute tech is light years beyond what we have. And a Courser chip is top of the line. I'm not going to get into details, but that chip could...
Basically, the ship allows the Courser or the Synth to teletransport back to the Institute. Because the Institute has no doors. That's how they get in, how they get in and how they get out.
Okay.
Fine.
But is it so a person is able to get in the same way?
Yeah, I hope so.
Let's have the circuit analyzer take a crack at you.
Hey, Tinker Tom.
Why do all women on this game look alike?
They don't. You're just talking about the
chip access.
Great.
Damn face models.
Hey, don't try anything.
Okay, this one is different.
See, these women are also different.
Yeah, this... Oh.
Oh, that's a doctor. Cool.
Oh, man. They've added more decimals to the last lifer. This is gonna be... Come on, baby. Show me that pattern.
Come on, baby. Show me that pattern. Oh, yeah. That's how he gets the chicks.
He'll get that chick.
It's the two bastard. I got you.
Lamp? Is that a lamp? It looks like a lamp.
Show me that
and the typewriter.
Well, meanwhile, I think I can.
We got the code.
Congratulations.
Hey, don't try anything, stranger. Good work.
Oh. Oh wait.
Okay.
I need to go there.
We need to go to Virgil. Who's Virgil?
Oh fuck! Seriously?
Virgil?
No, I know who's Virgil.
Careful, man. The Institute is everywhere.
You gotta be careful, man.
Man. You need to be careful.
Wait, where's the other chick?
She's gone.
Oh, there she is.
Hello. Hey.
If we're going to be dealing more with each other, I need to make sure that we're on the same page. You know what a synth is, right?
I've heard rumors. What are they, really?
The Institute created them. Synthetic humans. They're mostly organic. Part machine. Somewhere along the line, they became more than just constructs. They think, they feel, and they act just like you and me. The Institute treats synths as property, as tools.
Why does the Institute treat them that way?
They're playing God, tinkering with things they don't fully understand. From that lofty vantage, it's easy to deny their creation's very humanity.
Hmm.
That sounds like slavery.
Exactly. So we seek to free the synths from their bondage. Give them a chance.
I'm very good at this.
I have a question. The only question that matters. Would you risk your life for your fellow man? Even if that man is a synth? There's no middle ground with this. Would you risk death to save a synth or not?
I pledged my life to protect my countrymen. I don't see this as any different.
Well said. Someone with your skills, your beliefs. Normally, we'd try and recruit you. But right now, we don't have the time to train up a new agent. There are, however, other valuable ways you can contribute. And in turn, we can help you. See Deacon for details. You're free to go.
Let's go see Deacon.
Desdemona.
No. Oh, level up. Cool. I would actually go and help us out, but that has all the appearance of being a side quest. The perk shard. I hate this perk shard. I never know where to go.
A lot to choose.
Yeah, it's overwhelming. I actually would like to have more accuracy, but I don't know how. Perception, maybe? No, maybe this.
Yeah, it should come in handy.
We'll file out.
Oh yeah, that's the guy that gives me the. No, what I want is to just go to Virgil. Virgil was one of the most weird side quests I had. It's main quest, not side. What happened was, someone told me, like, Virgil was a scientist that worked with the Institute, and he could know how to get in and how to get out. But basically, he betrayed the Institute and had to run. And since apparently there's no running from the Institute, he had to go to a place where no one could find him. Basically, he went out to the Glowing Sea, which is an area of a map that is filled with radiation. You can't just walk there, and you're gonna die eventually if you go just by on foot.
Okay.
So I had to get the power armor and some fusion cores to just cross the freaking map.
Oh, nice.
The thing is, what just confused me the most, because I was looking at the map through the Pip-Boy on the smartphone, it looked like it was, and it is on the, after the edge of the map.
Oh.
It's like, you see this? I thought this was the edge, right? I mean, it kind of makes sense. It is.
It looks like, yeah.
See? But then where's Virgil? Virgil is here.
Ooh.
And like the Crypt Factory and Crater of Atom. Remember the guys from Fallout 3 who worshipped the bomb?
Oh, yeah.
Now they're here.
They're here, okay.
I mean, probably it's not the same persons, but they worship the same religion.
Turn to Virgil.
I would really. Okay, I can fast travel now.
Thank God.
I am not wearing any power armor, so I hope I don't get outside. Oh, this guy looks badass.
Unless you're hounding for a green suntan, I.
Fuck me! I went outside.
Yes. Still has radiation.
Yeah, but two reds, it's okay. The middle of the map was like 50, 70.
Damn it.
He had some turrets placed.
Virgil, where are you?
There's Virgil. Yeah, okay. This guy was.
I'm sure I'd see you again. You managed to get what you need.
Yeah.
I have the code.
Suppose I shouldn't be surprised. You did get rid of Kellogg after all. Not too much of a leap to take down a courser. How'd you manage to get it decoded?
Does it matter?
No, you're right. It doesn't really. The point is that you got it.
Nice.
Okay.
You're not the only one who's been busy. I did the best I could. From memory and things I've overheard through the years. Came up with some schematics for
I still know how we, why he wears the glasses.
These hands are ridiculous.
Yeah, because they have no
fine motor skills have gone to shit. Here's the symbol explanation. need to build a device that will hijack the signal the Institute uses to teleport coursers and send you instead. You know the craziest part of the design? That classical music station.
Seriously?
It's the carrier signal for the relay. All the data's on harmonic frequencies. You've been hearing it all along. I want to be clear that this isn't my area of expertise.
I've never seen
bioscience, not an
hipster mutant.
Advanced systems or anything.
This is what he is.
Good enough.
Sure it'll work.
For the record, I haven't made any promises, but if you can build this device and make use of that code, you should be able to override the signal from the Institute's relay. Can you? I mean, can you build it? You have people that can help. This is a lot for one person, even you.
Oh, you don't know me.
I got it covered.
Good, good. Because you've got to make it in there, for both our sakes. And don't you forget our agreement. I've helped you as best I can. If you make it in there, you find that serum. It's my only hope for ever being normal. So you find it. Now go on. Take these and get to work.
Can you really
you do
make it
whatever
back?
It takes. Call on whoever you know to help you.
Cause he's like super mutant.
Nick, get out. So I guess we should talk to everyone. The glowing sea. Oh, and just first time I got here, just for the record, before entering the cave, I had a Deathclaw like strolling by.
Of course.
I had a Deathclaw strolling by, right? Map. Let me check out the map. Where I should go first?
A lot of optional stuff.
Yeah, but first I should go to Sanctuary and speak to the Minuteman. Like, hey, can you help me out? I haven't seen you in ages! Why should I?
I don't care. Just help me out.
It's the life of my son that's at stake. Fuck you!
I don't care. I don't care about your son.
Oh, and Corsair took like four missiles to shoot down. For like not Fat Man missiles, but like rocket launcher missiles to take down.
Oh.
And
but are they robots? Are they
A Corsair is a synth.
It's a synth. It's that thing synth you talk about. Like
yeah.
The okay. Stronger ones.
At least I took his clothes.
That's nice.
I went full Schwarzenegger and said, give me your clothes, your boots. And it didn't have a motorcycle, but if it had, I would ask to.
Excuse me.
Hey, good to see you again. I was hoping you'd show up. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place.
No, I don't want to go into settlements.
Can you take a look at these schematics? Before a machine to get me inside the Institute.
I like how you ignored.
Yeah.
World would you want to mess around with
this looks like a nice place, right?
Yeah, I don't care what you're saying. Just help me.
I'd like to help, but look around. We can barely help ourselves right now. Maybe once I deal with the immediate problems. Speaking of which.
And there he goes again.
Settlement that needs help. They're still hoping there are Minutemen out there somewhere. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you can help out with the settlement?
I can't help right now.
That's your call. I hope you change your mind.
Yeah, like in 2 years. Hey, remember that settlement? And we used to need for help. Yeah.
They're dead.
I can go there now. Yeah, they're dead.
No, they're dead.
Okay, Minuteman can help. Can't help, actually.
We didn't need their help.
Yeah, we didn't need
their
help. Fuck that. That's the Brotherhood? Okay, College Square. Fuck, I haven't discovered this place yet. Let me check out the map closely so I can see the road. Probably here. Maybe this is the best option.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's a cute dog.
Remember, always go to your dentist.
Yeah. For real, man.
And eat something, for God's sake. Look at this.
Damn it.
Last time I was here, I had an encounter with Myrlorks, and that was not pretty at all.
Whee.
I still wish the game had vehicles. Just for the record.
Well, at least you can run. But anyways...
Yeah, but run...
How's your ability points since the last time we played the game?
It sucks.
It still sucks, okay.
I mean, you can check it out. You go to stats and... this is my special, like... They're not bad.
Yeah, but just your bar goes down so fast.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
Makes sense. It does. I'm hearing gunshots again.
Always the gunshots.
You have no idea, man. Like, going through this wasteland is a pain in the ass. If you just want to stroll by and see the environment, just...
I was just thinking about it, because it seems that this game has a lot more enemies than the previous ones.
See? Goals. Oh. Because why not?
No. Leave me alone. I have a family.
Like, seriously?
No! Don't kill me.
Look, fuck me.
There's loads of them. What the hell?
Yeah, this looks like Horde mode from Gears of War. Fuck you.
Leave us alone. Oh, he's on fire. That was a strong punch. And you almost killed yourself there.
I almost killed myself there, yeah.
Doesn't matter. It worked. You don't care.
Fuck, I fell.
And
more? Seriously?
More of them. What the hell? Just leave us alone, for God's sake.
Nice shot.
Oh, nice.
Two. Fuck. Three would...
Yeah, you were asking for a lot.
Yeah.
Holy... What the hell?
There was another one there. Is it alright?
They're getting... Dance. They're getting intelligent. Was hiding. Stop right there, civilians. No unauthorized personnel are permitted beyond this point. What did you call me? Civilian?
I was told you can help me. I need to build a signal interceptor to get into the Institute.
That's not going to happen. Unless you're one of us, you're not setting foot inside the space.
We're into this alone, right?
Yeah.
If you're here to sign up, I might have some work you could assist us with. Then we can discuss whatever.
Okay, I see that we're not going to make it without doing any side quests.
I just need you to answer a few questions first.
Just...
We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
I already told you.
I'm just trying to survive out here, like everyone else.
The way you charged in and engaged those ferals, I find that a bit difficult to believe. Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Vault 111.
You're a vault dweller? Most people wouldn't admit to such a thing. I appreciate your honesty. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
Well, we could use their help, but...
I'll continue to help, but you owe me an explanation first.
So, you're gonna spill the beans?
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese.
Where?
I've been trying to send a distress call to our vessel at Boston International.
I don't see anyone else!
The signal's too weak to reach.
Well, thanks for the help.
If I may.
Proceed, Halen.
Oh, there you go. Now you appear.
Hello.
...for the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough.
Oh, there's a head. There's a head down there.
Is
he okay?
It's
not okay, right?
I don't know.
He was not okay.
Range transmitter. We infiltrate.
Okay, he was not okay.
Secure the transmitter and bring it back here.
They were not there.
Are you willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
Outstanding.
just get things straight. We're just helping you because we need your help.
You know what I'm going to do, right?
Halen, take Reese inside and find his wounds.
You're sure you don't know what I'm going to do?
What are you going to do?
I'm just going to...
try another one?
Basically. I couldn't care less for the side quests. Like, I mean, they are kind of important, but I don't really care.
Yeah, but I really think we're not gonna get any help.
Look at this weapon. Look at it. See? It's a loading minigame. Where you can look at various models. Okay,
but actually the
looking
models,
down the barrel off again.
The weapons models are really, really
no, you're not supposed
well
to. Yeah, they are.
Yeah, I really like the models on the weapons. And not only the models, but the sound of the weapons.
I completed fire support, really nice. Apparently.
Okay.
I didn't even know I had a quest named that. But this game just keeps getting me side quests from a bunch. Like, the other time I just bumped into a dude on Diamond City. And I was like, hey man, you could help me out. I have some things you could do. And like, boom, side quest. Seriously?
Why the hell? Does my face look like I'm gonna help you?
Yeah, like, what the fuck? Oh, no, that was not the answer.
It seems it does because everyone just keeps asking us for
maybe
help.
Because we're Glaucon.
Yeah, maybe because we're Glaucon. After six
if
episodes,
you know,
after
the pain
six
in the
episodes
ass
that
had
I didn't play, it's still Glaucon.
And now
he has glasses. Yeah.
Now I picked up the glasses and yeah. So this was a stupid puzzle that I couldn't figure out until I just stopped a bit and go, oh, now I see. The thing I had to type Royal Road.
When you tango
with Desdemona.
Ah, the Courser Killer returns.
Seriously, now that's my nickname?
What the hell?
Can you take a look at these schematics? A scientist named Virgil said they could get me inside the Institute.
Even if one of my own agents told me that, I'd be skeptical. And from a stranger? Listen, you're obviously talented. I believe you'd be a great asset to our organization. So, prove it. Run the op with Deacon. If everything checks out, then we can talk about this plan of yours.
This is what's going to happen. Get help to build the interceptor.
You think we're gonna need everybody?
I don't think so, but...
Well, they say it's optional, but...
Yeah, they say it's optional, but...
Sometimes it's not.
It's not gonna be optional, right? Like, Michelin is... schematics, where's our... Where... Is that it? That was nice. Uh-huh.
Oh. So yeah, we need help.
Guess what we're going to do? We're going to help Deacon.
Hope you didn't mind the reception. When you tango with the Institute, you gotta be careful when someone new gets on the dance floor.
Yeah, Elvis.
Your leader was just being cautious.
Yeah, we know we're all on the same team.
Exactly. I like this guy.
Kind of killed our chance at a friendly first impression, though. But it's all good now. I vouched for you, nobody got shot. Still, I would consider it a close personal favor if you didn't sell us out to the Institute. Thanks.
So tell me, why did you vouch for me?
In our little outfit, it's my job to know things.
Really?
I'm very
with
good.
Everything you've done, it's clear you're capable. A dangerous enemy. And I'm betting a valuable ally.
But why the trust? You can't be taking it all on faith.
I've heard a lot of things about you. Enough to want to give you a chance. So Dez wants me to make you a tourist. That's what we call someone who helps out with the odd job here and there. I'm just going to come out and say that.
Okay.
You got my attention.
I got a job. Too big for me, just perfect for the two of us.
The three, you mean? Out, because Nick's gonna get coming to Nick's coming too, of course.
Then, yeah, he's a nice bro. Need some help,
your buddies in the railroad got your back.
Well, sign me up then.
Perfecto. Let's meet up at the old freeway outside of Lexington. I'll fill you in.
I'll fill you in.
I get to do a full security sweep.
Imagine if I was playing with a female model. I would fill you in when you get there.
Like, yeah, that would sound. Maybe the lines would change. I don't know.
Maybe not.
Maybe not, or maybe not. Yeah.
Be a heck of funny. Oh yeah, the church was really creepy. You have no idea. Especially because I first didn't notice the door on the right. You enter through the left and the door to the real world is on the right. So I went to the back of the church and climbed to the tower and there was nothing.
Damn.
I was like, fuck.
Now what?
Where should I go, really? Fuck these quests. You see, that's the when I talked to you about when saying that the game didn't feel like you had like too much of a choice.
Yeah, because that's the game actually is telling us that it's optional, but it won't be.
Yeah.
Because it's gonna be make us do all the quests because we're gonna need all the teams to help us. That's what it seems, at least.
Where the fuck is Lexington? No, wait, I'm missing a quest here.
I think we...
No. Ah, I wasn't...
Where do you have... Oh, okay.
Oh, there's Lexington.
We found it. No, we don't want to change.
Why would we?
We want to play with Globe till the end.
I'm probably gonna do the side quests later. Like, just...
Yeah, of course, but...
Probably I'm gonna even start a new game and just see if there's another type of choices we can have. Because I don't see very much right now.
Well, if there's no... If there's not much of a choice, it's a shame, because usually, at least on Fallout 3...
You didn't have much of a choice in Fallout 3.
Not in the real story, but you had like a lot of outcomes for different characters. Main quest-specific characters, but you had a lot of different characters with many, many stories. Depending on the choices you make.
The thing is, like, I'm going on the wrong direction. There was only one direction.
Holy.
Oh
my god.
And I missed it.
Man.
I think I missed it. Yeah, now I'm going right. The thing is, like, even Fallout 3 didn't have much of a choice, because when you got to the end, I'm not counting DLC stuff, of course, because...
Oh! No. No. Just stay there.
That's probably mutant.
Don't mess with us.
No?
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, but...
Because I don't know if you actually got to the end of 3 several times, but... The only thing that changed on the endings was like 2 or 3, 4 lines of dialogue in each sequence.
Yeah.
It's like the outcome of some quests you did, but in the end you basically just enter the chamber and die.
Yeah, with the main story, basically, yeah. But with the side quests, you had a...
Yeah, with side quests, you had a lot of things to do. But that didn't happen, like, in Fallout 2. I know it's a different company, of course, but... in Fallout 2, like, you really had different outcomes on the main story.
Yeah. I would like to see more of, like, Spec Ops... like where you had 9 different outcomes at the end of the game, and none of them were like a real ending. All of them were spectacular. I love all the endings from the game, and none of them were the real ending. You could just choose.
Is this? That's Deacon?
It's Deacon. It's changed. He's not Elvis Deacon? Anymore.
Is that you?
Like the disguise? It's Wasteland? This is my pile of garbage.
Okay.
Asshole. Back off.
Good, right? You're lucky I didn't do one of my face swaps, too. What
the hell?
You can change your face?
I put myself under the knife every year or two. New face, new body. You know, the full makeover. It keeps our enemies guessing.
You're a strange guy.
I almost didn't recognize you.
That's the point. So, about the
that was weird.
Now he looks a lot more like using the old Blade Runner.
Our old base was underneath the Slocum's.
Blade Runner was not bald.
Pretty sweet setup until the
instant. No, but his outfit, it looks Blade Runner-ish.
Your base was under a donut shop?
It's a lot better than it sounds. Well, it was until it was blown to hell.
That sounds really, really bad.
It was a disaster with a capital D. The survivors didn't have time to grab anything. So we're getting something important we had to leave behind.
What exactly are we looking for?
I'll tell you when we get inside.
All this is secrecy.
We got a tourist nearby.
Look at the
friend. He or she has information on the base. So let's pump him for information before we dive in. For now, I'll take point. If you like that, we got signs and countersigns, dead drops, even a secret handshake. Anyway, the tourist should have a trail left for us. Here we go.
That thing?
The arrow in the center indicates a direction.
Whoa, really, man?
Let's keep going.
Really complicated.
Let's
keep going.
That's over the top, man.
Like real arrow, pro stuff.
Yeah, the arrow gives a direction. What the hell?
Nothing here.
The game hasn't saved for a while.
Yeah,
you should do it.
I'm getting better with the pistol.
Yeah. And we're strong. I see we're stronger than.
Yeah, we're stronger. The pistol's also better.
Yeah, the beginning of the game was really hard.
Of course!
Walking Dead style.
Yeah, Walking Dead, really. Come on, get out.
There you go.
Just so you see.
Is it gonna... Oh... That looks awesome.
Ta! Where's Deacon? Seriously, you're waiting for me there?
Why? Oh no, now he's acting like he was waiting for us. Okay, yeah.
Yeah,
fine.
Go to the other side.
Yeah. I don't like this guy.
Seriously?
What the hell are you doing, man? Just... What?
Let me see if I can light the thing on fire.
Easy.
It looked like...
Yeah. The guy is high, isn't he? He doesn't know what he's doing.
Probably is on drugs, yeah. I mean, for a guy that looks like Elvis, on the next second, it looks like...
Probably close.
Indiana Jones. Oh, there was another sign I totally missed.
He doesn't care.
Doesn't.
He doesn't. He just keeps walking through the.
But most of them just don't care. It's like even when they talk to someone, they just kind of have this conversation, and you try to interrupt them. But the game doesn't let you, and they just keep talking, and suddenly their script event just ends, and they turn to you like, hey, how was your day? Like that conversation before never happened.
Yeah.
You take point on the
typical
conversation. Look, no matter what he says, you just say, mine is in the shop. Trust me.
Well, I don't trust you, but...
Oh, that's the tourist. Okay.
Hello, buddy.
Hey there. Dalton.
Ricky Dalton.
Excuse me.
Oh, thank God. You have a Geiger counter? You have a goddamn Geiger counter?
Of course he's a cowboy.
Mine is in the shop.
Who the hell is he? HQ said they were sending one agent, not two.
Sorry, I'm new. He's just showing me the ropes.
All right. The wall is my witness. I thought I was dead. It's about goddamn time you headquarters bastards got here.
Tell me what's going on.
I signed on for some light recon, but that little Slocum's Joe of yours is crawling with goddamn chrome dome synth sons of bitches. The front's forked by the hell and back. They place mines all over the goddamn place.
What do you mean by chrome dome synths?
You know, them early model synths. Looks like metal wrapped over mechanical innards. You see them here and there doing who knows what for the Institute.
They have a minefield?
Yeah, the mother of all...
The mother of all minefields.
I could draw you a map if I tried.
I appreciate all you've done.
I hope it helps. I really do. As soon as it's safe, I'm getting the hell out of here. So if you need anything else, better ask soon.
Deacon.
Excuse me.
Well, excuse me, this guy is so... Sunshine.
You think he's telling the truth?
Yeah.
Speaking of truth... Why did you lie to Ricky?
My job in the railroad is intel. That job's easier if no one knows who I am. So, I lied. I do that. So you handled the talky-talk, and I got to watch from the sidelines.
It's just good to know.
Go team us.
Why would Ricky lie?
People always got reasons to lie. The Institute could have turned him. Or, more likely, he's just seriously pissed off at us. Take your pick.
He doesn't strike me as the dishonest type.
Yeah, that's my read, too. First rule of this business is never go against your gut. So, if we take him at his word, the front door has mines, synths, and probably other fun and exciting prizes. So, we're going in through the escape tunnel.
The donut shop has an escape tunnel?
What the fuck?
Doesn't have an escape tunnel?
No.
Seriously, though?
I mean, I don't.
If it weren't for that, there wouldn't be any railroad left.
Besides, I live on the first floor, like, my escape tunnel would probably just go off into the air and die.
Yeah, that would not
I would die from a fall.
Yeah.
That entrance is a drain pipe. It's not too far from here.
It's seriously getting on my nerves. Yep, that's too high.
Hey, Ricky.
Need something else?
Yeah. Maybe it's sniper fire.
We're assaulting the base. Once we strike, use your rifle to pick off anyone you can see. A lot of lives are depending on us.
You silver tongue son of a bitch. All right, I'll take a couple shots. If I see any of them coming from
me, I'm running from the hills.
We're done.
Okay, we need to get down, right?
Should be able to take him instead of Deacon.
I don't want to take him instead of Deacon.
Deacon doesn't do anything.
We have Nick.
Yeah, Nick is fine.
Look at me playing with fire.
Playing on the edge.
Yeah, living on the edge actually. That's probably the right wording for.
Why? Oh my God! Why are you doing this to me?
I think I can get down here. Yeah.
Yeah, that's where we got up.
Okay, we try. 90 meters. Or yards, inches, I don't know.
Let's just go with meters, because that's what we use.
Let's go with units. 90.
Units. Okay, yeah.
47 units to go.
Or steps.
Or steps. Steps would be another guy thing.
It looks like steps. Yeah.
Yeah. Let me just ready my gun out. Oh, that's the entrance. Well,
let's just say it's close.
Ta-da!
Oh! Super.
You know what I'm gonna do now?
Save?
I'm going to save the game.
Always good to save the game.
I'm going to save the game.
We're in. The back entrance is safer, but be ready for Gen 1s and 2s.
Yeah, fuck it. I'm
so
going to save.
It's time you learn why we're here. We're retrieving a prototype developed by our good Dr. Carrington.
Oh, this high.
Computer.
If that's a master terminal, I can't unlock it. Oh, but Deacon probably has a password. I can pickpocket Deacon.
No way I'm cracking this.
Oh, the Nick also has a thing that Count. It's this.
One. Think you can unlock that terminal?
Oh.
And do.
That it is. Doesn't always unlock. If I push Deacon there.
Oh.
He's enjoying himself.
Hi. We're in. The back entrance is safer, but be ready for Gen 1s and 2s.
Sure, that was good.
So it's time you learn why we're here. We're retrieving a prototype developed by our good Dr. Carrington.
Right. Yeah, you told us already.
A slightly different approach.
Who's Dr. Carrington?
All goes well. You'll meet him soon enough.
What can you tell me about the Gen 1s and 2s?
The synths didn't start off as nigh-perfect copies of human beings. The Institute had to work up to that level of hubris. Gen 1s and 2s were stepping stones along the way. The Railroad's not fully united on how we feel about them.
What's there to be divided?
Everyone wants to liberate the Gen 3s, the human-looking synths. Some of the synths in the Railroad, like Glory, think we should help earlier models too. But Gen 1s are basically the same as, well, a Protectron. So the line gets muddy. Do we defend AI rights? Terminals? Hell, turrets?
Yeah.
Anytime it gets brought up, fireworks. All the old arguments flare up. The upshot is Glory and some others won't run missions like this.
Eager to go.
First step is to override the security.
Yeah, our friend Nick. Did he do it?
Nope.
He didn't. You bastard. Oh, he's gonna do it. Deacon's gonna do it.
Well, the terminal's on at least. I'm gonna feed it some passwords. No. Nope. No. Ah, missed one, you goddamn bastards. The prototype's deeper inside.
Okay.
Someone left a rail sign here. This one is dangerous.
Oh wait, didn't we level up? Like...
Yeah, ages ago.
Ages ago.
I totally forgot.
Oh, there is... Vault Boy on steroids. Look.
Steady aim.
Yeah, he's on steroids. Look at his arm.
Okay, I think I'm gonna go with this one. Why not?
Alright.
Wouldn't want it going to waste now, would we?
Oh, you don't let people naked now?
Oh no, I just stopped doing
change
that.
A lot since the last time we played.
Oh, there's a synth. I totally failed. Again. Why? He still didn't see me.
It seems like you're failing, but you're not.
No, I totally did.
Yeah, you did.
Seriously?
No.
I'm going to die.
Is he? Is strong?
No, I'm just playing like shit.
But he is. He wrecked us.
See?
Okay.
He was not strong. I was just really playing lousy. Okay, that was that was an overkill.
Box in the center of that rail sign. Looks like Maven managed to hide something before. Well, you know, look around. Tinker managed to turn on the defenses, barely slowed the coursers down, but hey, probably saved some lives.
I should kill that thing, right?
Detected. That was. Was that a camera or something?
I think that was a camera. Fuck.
Yeah, they are not very strong.
No, no, they aren't. I was...
It seemed to me like you were doing no damage.
No, no, I was totally missing the shot.
Okay, yeah.
See?
That was nice.
I'm running out of team packs. And I need to finish the episode. Who the fuck are you? Shut up. Are the turrets on? No. But that was a camera. There is a camera somewhere. See? Oh, it was just a light.
It's just a searchlight.
Someone was expecting trouble.
Hello, friend. We're asking.
Yeah, someone. Fuck. Fuck! Get out! Just one small notice. The same button to open the inventory is the same button open to reload. Like when you want to explore a corpse or a chest or something, it's the same button to reload. Oh. So if you're reloading in mid-battle and it just happens to pass your cursor on a chest or on a body, basically it just opens the body.
Another active terminal. We didn't have time to check the defenses up ahead. Power them up. We can give our friends a little surprise.
We're gonna give them surprise on the next episode.
Yeah.
Because I'm running out of time. The one here? Just check it out.
Is someone present?
Yes, your mama.
Hello.
Nope. Can I save? I can save.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna save. We're gonna continue this on the next episode. And once again, thank you for accompanying me on
okay.
this.
Okay, thank you for having me. And see you guys on the next episode.
Yeah, bye guys. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.